The 80s was great for R&B music, but no young group enjoyed success like New Edition. With their self-titled album released in 1983, these five guys from Roxbury seemed destined for greatness. But money, egos almost tore them apart. This is not that story. Well, it kinda is. This is the real untold Michael Bivins story. Here on Forgotten Stars of R&B.
In 1983, New Edition was riding high with their hit single, Candy Girl. But little did the world know, they were hiding a secret that would haunt them forever. So tell us your name.
My name is Michael Lamont Bivins. I'm actually the original guy from New Edition.
So how could that be?
You see, the fellas, they kicked me out when we was younger and they replaced me with the guy y'all see today, whose name actually isn't even Michael Bivins. It's actually Craig.
You know, tell us your side of the story.
My side of the story?
Yeah.
All right, I'll tell you my side. Because see, I remember it like it was just yesterday. It was a cold winter day down in Boston, Massachusetts. Roxbury, to be exact.
We gotta take stuff slow. They gonna think we joking. The only thing we want is that money and everything.
Yeah.
Hold on. Hey, bro, me and Mike gonna start single.
Yeah, we gonna call ourselves New Edition.
What? That's cool. Can I join?
Yeah, that'll be fresh.
Yo, Ricky, you wanna be in our singing group?
Sure, man. I can't sing.
Whoa, it's my group. I'm the lead team. Y'all just my background.
And I'm gonna talk for all the songs, so don't none of y'all try to steal that part.
Yeah, so yeah, it's settled.
Yo, y'all think we can use somebody else to play Jack's Five?
Yo, good idea. We can use Brooke Payne and Ronnie.
Yeah, long as he don't want to sing Lee.
Yo, thanks, fellas, for letting me in the group.
No problem, Ronnie.
No problem, Ronnie. Hey, man, did you hear about that talent contest that Maury Starr's giving? I think we should enter.
Yeah, I heard about it. It sounds like a great idea.
This sucker!
I'm sorry, man.
Nah, I wanna fight now.
You wanna fight your old bag of candy?
Man, I hate him!
He's just mad because I knocked the bag of candy out of his hand when we were looking at this girl.
We need to cool it now.
Yeah, man, y'all really need to cool it.
Come on, Ralph, let's go take a walk.
I'm going with him.
You okay, man?
Yeah, I'm good.
Well, I'm gonna cut that though. You coming?
Nah, man, help me out.
We're going to be at my house for rehearsal at 7. I hope you're there.
All right, I'll be there.
My. Those dudes are half crazy.
And the next thing I know, the fellas was out on tour. They were selling out shows, doing concerts all over the world with this fake mic. They replaced me. And now this dude has reaped all the benefits that I'm supposed to get. He out working for TNT. You know, doing all that stuff, and I'm still here living in Roxbury, you know, with my mom sleeping on her couch.
Yeah, I remember those boys. They used to come up to my house. Yeah.
When they was young, they was gonna start a group with my son. I got some pictures of them right here. Yeah.
Here go little Ralphie right here. Always used to come to my house and ask for grape Kool-Aid. Yeah. And here go little Bobby right here. He was a badass. But for the most part, those kids was all right. But that's messed up what they did to my son. But he gonna be all right. He gonna be all right.
Look, now y'all see what I'm saying? I mean, I'm not making this stuff up. This is actually a known fact in the whole New Edition circle. I mean, somewhat.
Because this was starting to piss me off, I figured I'd dig deeper into this story to uncover the truth. So we here at Forgotten Stars of R&B went to talk to family and friends close to New Edition.
I've been cool with these fellas for a long time, and I heard about this, but I always thought it was a rumor, you know, something like the Loch Ness Monster or Bigfoot, or even that if you mix a Pop Rocks and soda that you can die. At any rate, who knew?
I think I remember my dad mentioning that once when I was a kid, but he never brought it up again. And I do remember Mike being, I remember him being taller. I don't know, he looks way different now than he did then. But I guess it's kind of like the mother from Fresh Prince, or like Lionel from The Jeffersons. Who knew?
You know, the fellas have went on and they've gotten big. Ricky, he living out in L.A. I don't know where Bobby be half the time. Johnny's out in L.A. Ron and Ralph, you know, they down in Atlanta. You know, man, I get a little upset about this, but, you know, I know eventually the truth will come to light. They'll realize what they did to me. And they'll, you know, hopefully we'll do like a reunion tour. Till then, I'm just here back in Roxbury.
Since this interview, Ralph and the real Mike have patched things up and the fellas have let him back in the group. Which has this reporter asking the question, what will happen to the fake Mike Bivins? And who cares? This is Forgotten Stars of R&B, and I am Jay Jones. Tune in next week when we uncover the dark secrets of Color Me Bad. I'm gonna take a ride.